Hello, in this video, let's create beam system from hollow core slab. So let's go to our project and let's prepare for this task. So first I need to have building structure level. So I need to create this floor level in which I will put my slabs. So I go to views, I select structure plan, and from here I select building structure, second floor, and elevation 2.9. Let's create OK. Let's change discipline to structure. So in this case, let's select scope box and it will nicely crop our view. Let's change scale to 150. And in this case, I see on the structure sections. And of course, in this case, view range is important. So in my case, I have -310. So my floor thickness, I can make it a little bit deeper. And in this case, I will use zeros for cut plane and top. If you need to know more about this view range, you can read this example or read more in the help file. So here I can see a representation of my floors. In this case, I will use fine, but I don't need walls in fine representation. So let's use medium. And for walls, let's change walls to represent cores. Yes. So I just need my floors, and in the dashed line represented by my walls. I can turn off this crop view. For me, it's better to look. And now I will need to put my hollow core slabs. So what kind of slabs I will use in this case? So in this case, I should check what is my thickness of my structure floor. So I see it's 200. So I need to insert some additional models from library. So I go to my library manager. I go to structure framing, precast concrete. And from here, I should look for hollow core slabs. So I have special folder for hollow core slabs, and in here you see I have some examples downloaded from other libraries. So I will choose basic one, which is in default library of Revit, so this one, and let's place it in the project. And let's go to the project and let's select structure beams. And here you can see my slabs. So typical slabs is width 1200 and in my case thickness 200. So I select this slab and I will put in this location. Let's check if all the settings are selected correctly. Okay, simple line on grids. No, I don't want place on grids. Okay, let's just create one floor slab. So in this case, slabs are acting like beams, and you see it's automatically joins and attaches to the wall. So in my case, it's not acceptable. So I use disjoin tool and I disjoin this slab. So I can manage this by hand. Also, slabs should not go on the top of bearing walls. So this wall is bearing wall from the staircase. So my slab side part should be side by side with this wall. Next, I need to know how much I should put my slab on the floors. So for this case, I go to internet. I look for some kind of precast concrete factories, and these factories have some information for designers, some PDF files, and if I go to these PDF files, I have such a connection representation. So here I have some examples. How should I put my slab on my walls? So first you see two pictures. They represent if you are using masonry units, so it's recommended at 120 on the masonry units, so it can be thin or thick wall of masonry. Also, if you put slabs from both sides, so here also you see masonry wall and 120 from one side, 120 from the other side, and you should put some gap which you will use to connect these slabs. So the same here, you see this concrete part, it's for fixing the slab to the wall. And this example represents if you are connecting or putting your wall on the concrete walls. So in this case, you can put support of 100 millimeters and between these slabs 30 millimeters. So let's go back to my example. And for this purpose, I will use reference plane, which will help me to guide my slabs. So I put from both sides these reference lines. So they are very useful. They are acting like grid lines or levels, but they are not printable, and they sometimes can help you a lot. So I put it on 20 because my wall is made from masonry. And here, 120. I can measure what is the distance between these reference lines. You see, 6, 0, 10. So I select my floor, 6, 0, 10. And it stretches from both ends. And I have nice slab here. I should see its representation. Let's move this section 2 in here. Okay, let's do like that. So in here you see my slab. And of course you should connect everything, join, and it nicely connects with my concrete part. Also, I can do the same using structure beam system, and let's say I want to use sketch beam system. I will use simple line, I will use reference lines which I used before, and let's say okay, so my beam system should start from here and also from this wall. Direction of beam system should be this, and I just use trim and trim around. So fixed distance 1200, hollow core slab 1200, and yeah, I press OK, and it automatically puts all the slabs in this location. So I can choose one or another example how I can put these slabs. If I use beam system, so it also has the same issue with connecting parts. So in this case, I need to unpin these parts and say I don't want to disallow joint. Disallow joint. And 6-0 then. Also, it's available using maybe other techniques, but in this case, I just show this not very user-friendly technique how to change it. But if you do it like that, you will know it's correct. So if you have a big floor, so beam system can help you save some time. If you have small floor, so maybe it's easier to just use and create these beams just one by one. Next, let's change my floor material to other concrete materials, so I can see representation of this slabs connecting the floors in a little bit different way. Okay, I will choose concrete, and this one. Okay. So now you see my hollow core slab is on the wall, and it's 120 from the bearing part of the wall, and let's join everything so I can go here, modify, join. Okay, let's save. So don't forget to save each time you make some changes, multiply join, and let's say I want to join this part, multiply, and I just join all the parts. And you see some parts here will be filled with concrete. Of course, this slab is not very correctly represented in this project, because in real projects, concrete is not filled inside these holes, so you need special concrete slabs which don't have such problem. In real projects we have such, but for education purpose it's, I think it's okay. Okay, so let's go now, and let's say I want to put additional floor slab in maybe some part. So I will move my beam system a little bit to the right side. Okay, let's see, it's okay. And I would like to put here additional slab. So I have 380 millimeters. So for this purpose, I should go and check what are available floors cutting by the manufacturer recommendations. So each manufacturer represents such tables and gives such information. And you see, this is 200, and I can have this part cut it from 260 to 320, so it's cuttable part. So each slabs is cutted in this location of this empty hole void. So this part you see is 320, is the smallest one. So in my project it's okay, so I can create such object. So I create additional slab, I go to the 3D model, I will isolate this slab, and I will use special tools to cut it. So by face, and okay, and it doesn't catch this floor. So you can use several cutting types, so by face or just cutting by reference line, but in this case the floor part is too small, so I should use cutting by face. Okay, it wants to cut in this plane. No. Okay, so maybe I need to see some additional framing stuff, location line. Okay. It doesn't seem to work. So let's create outside the floor slab. Yeah, so you should have this green arrow, and let's put it here, and I need 320, and let's put it, and let's constrain these parts. Green, and let's press finish, and you see it's cutted nicely here. Now I need to put it back to this location, so I will delete this one. Restore temporary files, and I need to select the opening cut and the structure framing, and use move tool, and I move it nicely inside here to this reference line. And joining. Join. Now you see these dashed lines represent the inside empty parts of my slabs. So on the floor slab plan, it's not looks very good. So I will try to fix it. So I go to framing part, and let's just use hide and lines, and let's turn it off. And another way, I think it's not just slab and floor height and lines. Yeah. Now I have nicely created these parts, and I can just put dimensions, connect them to the grid lines. So grid location sometimes depends from the construction of hollow core slabs and construction of walls. So sometimes it's recommended to put, if the wall is made from masonry units, so the grid line can be 120 from the wall structure, wall part. In this case, the grid line is in the middle of the wall, so it depends from the configuration of the project. And of course I should tag these slabs. In this case I didn't load any tags, so I should tag them. I have dimensions, length, width, and connection to the lines. And of course I should represent how much it weighs on the walls. According to drawing requirements, on the height line we don't put dimensions, but in this case we make an exception and we can put it and show just like that. And here is, if I connect, I see concrete fills all the empty parts, and my hollow core slab is created nicely, and I have nice drawing. Need to put some dimensions between lines, and I can put it inside a triangle.